Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 38, featuring Danny Thomas, Raymond Burr, Mel Blanc, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
The House of Squibb, manufacturing chemist of the medical profession since 1858, brings you Academy Award. The pictures, the players, the techniques and skills which have won or been nominated for, the coveted awards granted each year by the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences to each in his field for outstanding achievement. The House of Squibb, makers of the great family of Squibb medicinal products, today brings you John Garfield in Pride of the Marines with Rosemary DeCamp. Pride of the Marines is the dramatic picture which was nominated for the 1945 Academy Award as the best written screenplay of the year. Our star, Mr. Garfield, was nominated as the best supporting actor of the year for the 1938 Academy Award.
This is the story of an heroic Marine. In its way, it's the story of other heroic American fighting men, too, whose qualities in battle, whose qualities in the even grimmer struggle for rehabilitation, made these American soldiers the pride of the free world. This is the story of a boy who's the pride of the Marines, Al Schmidt, United States Marine Corps. The story of Al Schmidt begins on an island where the scourge of the Japanese advance was first checked, Guadalcanal.
They're coming again, Schmidt. Keep down, they'll be coming any minute now. They won't come from where they're shooting. I think they're going to cross the river.
Okay, Diamond, how about cutting this gun in?
Wait. Now, fire! Those hand grenades. Let him have it. Oh! They got Johnny! They got Johnny!
Oh, you yellow-bellied, dirty, stinking, slimy pigs! The best guy in the world.
Watch it. Coming in again.
Diamond!
Push me out of your way.
Where you hit? Where
shoulder.
You hit?
Get me out of your way. I'll stick with it. Stick. Don't let him through.
Lee, don't kick off. We'll get help soon. I don't want to be alone, Lee. Dirty skibbies. Try and sneak one up on me, huh? You ain't coming so fast anymore. Don't like what you're getting, do you? Come on, suckers. There's nobody in your way. Just a couple of Marines. Oh! I can't see. Right in the face. My eyes. I can't see. I can't see, Lee. I can't see.
Al, don't do it. We'll get help soon. Put down that 45. Don't shoot yourself.
Shoot myself? Just tell me where they are, Lee. Tell me where they're coming from, Lee. Tell me where they are.
Back home, a Marine sweetheart gets a letter from a sailor aboard a hospital ship. A girl back in Philadelphia hears about Al Schmidt.
Dear Ruth, Al asked me to write this letter on account of he can't do any writing now. I am a sailor and am taking care of his legs. An infection. But that's clearing up. I will tell you honestly and truly, though, that he is a hero. And I do mean hero. Al says he will be coming home one of these days and hopes to see you real soon. Lots of love, Al Schmidt. You see, folks, he says Al's all right. But then why couldn't Al write himself?
And as for the Red Cross workers here in San Diego Base Hospital, why, they're okay. Even the blonde one who brings me a letter. But as for me, I'll take a girl named Ruth every time.
Ah, come on, pal. This is the first letter you've written yourself. Give a little. Big. Think how she wants to come to you.
Well, what'll I say?
Oh, you want to tell her about your gang?
Oh, sure, yeah. We got a great gang of gyrenes here, Ruthie. A lot of them from the canal. Lee Diamond, who was with me, Kababian. Where's that ashtray, Blondie?
On the desk, right by your hand. Your right hand, Al.
Oh, thanks.
Well, how about the rest of the letter?
Oh, that's enough.
Isn't there anything else you want to tell her, Al?
Like what?
About your eyes.
No.
Well, she'll have to know sometime.
Look, after I have my operation, after I can see again. Well, then I'll tell her. Then it'll be a big laugh for the both of us, understand?
You know, there's an operation scheduled for you tomorrow morning.
Well, sure, they told me. Bet you thought I'd be scared or something. Well, this is what I've been waiting for. This is going to fix me up.
Al, the doctor doesn't promise you'll be able to see after this operation. Maybe you'll...
He doesn't have to promise. I know them doctors. Like the one on the ship who was always saying I might lose a leg from blood poisoning. Didn't, did I? Here, add something to that letter, will you, Ruthie? Here, to Ruthie. Ruthie, I've been holding out the best news to the end. You keep asking me why I don't write to you myself. Well, the reason is my hands. I caught some shrapnel in them like a dumb bunny. But any day now, you'll be getting a letter every day written by yours truly himself.
Al, this isn't any good. You're just storing up trouble for yourself, for both of you.
Don't be a killjoy, Blondie. Here I am on top of the world. And take this from me, will you? It won't be long before I come walking up the steps of your house, Ruthie. And don't you worry about my hands, baby. When I get them on you, you'll know they're all right. Gosh, sweetheart, I can hardly wait to see you.
I'll say it, Al. Just make believe I'm a typewriter. Don't be embarrassed.
I can hardly wait to kiss you for the first time, honey. I never told you what I feel like when you're in my arms. Looking up at me with your eyes like, with that kind of funny, wonderful light in your eyes, like you did on that railroad platform when I went away.
Say it, Al.
Lots of love, your brown-eyed devil. She used to call me that once. It's a kind of joke between us, see?
Yeah.
Blondie, look at this picture. Ain't that a nice face, though, ain't it? Here, come here, take a look.
No, Smitty, I just looked at it a little bit ago.
Well, don't rip me. I only showed it to you once.
Yeah, it's a very nice face, Al. A guy could lean on a girl like that.
A Marine don't lean on anybody. If there's any leaning to be done, the female sex the weaker, ain't it?
Well, most people lean a little on somebody. Nobody stands alone.
Well, you just let me have that operation, Blondie. I'll stand alone. You just watch me.
Thanks, nurse. Well, I guess we're ready for you now, Smitty.
Not too soon for me, Doc. I'm busting at the seams. It's been the longest 3 weeks of my life.
Now, look, Smitty, don't expect to see the minute the bandage is off, huh? I've darkened the room so as not
okay.
to...
Okay. You told me that, Doc. Just get it off, will you?
Now, I'm not making any promises either. The healing process
is... Okay, but let's try it. Please.
Bandage is off now.
No! Not a darn thing. But I didn't expect to see with the blinds down. You said it was dark in here. How about the flashlight? You promised...
I will. But now take it easy.
Turn it on, Doc. Even if it's only a 2-bit flashlight. I'm going to see stars and angels and Ruth. Come on, Doc. Let me see the light. Bring it closer.
See anything?
Yeah. Like a locomotive headlight. Way off in the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.